In this video, we are going to look at the cervical rotation lateral flexion test for first rib hypomobility in patients with brachialgia and thoracic outlet syndrome. Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Lindgren and colleagues argue that hypomobility of the first rib within the upper aperture of the thoracic cage can cause neural irritation and lead to symptoms known as thoracic outlet syndrome and limit cervical range of motion as well. In 1990, they came up with the cervical rotation lateral flexion test to assess hypomobility of the first rib, and 2 years later assessed this test's inter-radar reliability and validity against syneradiography in assessing first rib elevation. In a sample of 23 patients, they found an excellent kappa value of 1 and a positive test correlated with limited elevation of the first rib on syneradiography. The sample in the study is fairly small and it's the only study that ever described this test, so the clinical value remains questionable at least. To conduct the test, the patient is in sitting position. The patient's head is rotated away from the affected side, and then lateral flexion is added in the opposite direction than the rotation so that the ear moves towards the patient's chest. The test is positive if there is no movement of lateral flexion along the axis of the costal transverse joint or if bony restriction blocks the movement. Thanks for watching this video. Make sure to check out our other videos on thoracic outlet syndrome on the left. Before you go though, check out the video description right below the like button for more info on this video, our assessment book and app, or our recently launched online course. As always, this was Andreas for Physiotutors. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.